We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
A very good morning, good afternoon, good night, whenever you will watch this video. So today we have one new topic, which is you have to prove that Cp by Cv is equals to gamma. Now Cp means what? Specific heat at constant pressure. Cv means what? Specific heat at constant volume. And gamma means what? Adiabatic index. So whenever in your examination, supposing this type of question will ask that to prove that Cp by Cv equals to gamma. So which thing will come in your mind? Which process in short will come in your mind? Cp, every process, any process Cp is present. Cv is also present in any process. But gamma is what? It is an adiabatic index. So which process will come in your mind? That adiabatic process. That means Cp by Cv equals to gamma, that you have to prove for adiabatic process. Now how will start? That as we know, the second law of thermodynamics. Now second law of thermodynamics is what? That is your dQ is equals to dU plus dW. Now why this is the second law? Why that first law, my mistake, dq equals to du plus dw. So for that I have already prepared one video in thermodynamics A, B and C. So in these three parts I have explained zeroth law, first law, second law, third law in detail. So you can watch this and come over here or right now accept it, that it is the first law of thermodynamic, and that first law of thermodynamic we will apply on adiabatic process, because that is your gamma is a adiabatic index. Now as we know that first of all, that is Q means what? Heat transfer. That is your changing internal energy. Changing into internal energy means what? It is neither heat nor work, but it is one type of stored energy. W means what? It is the work done. dW means what? Change in work done. Over here we are talking about a process, that is why change in work done we will say. But supposing if we will talk about a single point, so we will write as W. Over here process is there 1, 2, 2. So over here some work W1, over here some work W2. So dW we have to write if you want to consider a process, which is W2 minus W1. So that is known as dW. Similarly for dU also. Now as we are talking about adiabatic process, because we have to prove Cp by Cv, which is an adiabatic index. So in adiabatic process, what's happened? That heat transfer is zero and work transfer is possible. So over here, if you want to write down this equation once again by considering heat transfer as zero, so what you will say? That dq means what? It will represent heat transfer. So heat transfer is zero. So dq equals to zero. Remaining is du plus dw. Now same equation I can write like this. dU plus dW is equals to 0. Simply I am interchanging the term. After that, dU means what? Change in internal energy. Change in internal energy means what? MCV dT or delta T, standard equation is there. Plus dW means what? Work done. Work done by which process? We are talking about which process? We are talking about adiabatic process. So we have to write down the work done by adiabatic process. And work done by adiabatic process is what? It is your MR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. That equation already we have proved in thermodynamics video number 04 or 05, I think. Over there you can go and you can derive this equation easily. So work done by adiabatic process is what? MR T1 minus T2 upon gamma minus 1, which is equals to 0. Now further which thing we can write? We can write like this, that MCV dT means what? Temperature difference. So final temperature T2 minus initial temperature T1 plus MR. Achha. Now supposing if that term if I want to keep over there, see, in the next step we will do so, plus MR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1 equals to 0. So MCV T2 minus T1 is equals to, now this term if I want to keep over here, so which thing I have to do? I have to keep it as negative sign. So minus MR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. After that, what I can do? MCV T2 minus T1 is equals to, now that negative sign, when it will multiply with this term, whole term, so what's happened? That T1 will be negative and T2 will be positive. So as T2 will be positive, I multiply this negative sign with T2. So that will be your MR. T2 is positive, positive, negative, negative, positive, and T1 will be negative. T1 divided by gamma minus 1. Over here I will write T2 minus T1 divided by gamma minus 1. So from this term, what you can observe over here, M will be cancelled out. Then next is that whole term T2 minus T1, T2 minus T1 will cancel. So remaining is what over here? It will be only CV, which is equals to, that will be your R divided by, remaining is what? Gamma minus 1. Now simply cross multiplication. So CV multiplied with gamma minus 1, that is your cross multiplication, which is equals to only R. Now CV multiply with gamma, CV gamma, negative sign, minus CV into 1, so it will be CV as it is, which is equals to R. Then what we will do? CV gamma minus CV. Now instead of R, what we can write? R is equals to CP minus CV. Already this thing I have proved in my video. So R is what? Universal gas constant, which is CP minus CV. Now over here, CV, negative sign is CV, CV will get cancelled. So remaining is what? CV gamma is equals to CP. So I will keep gamma as it is, CP as it is, and CV at the bottom side. And I can write like this. Finally, what? CP by CV is equals to gamma for adiabatic process. So that is what? That is the relationship between specific heat, then specific heat at constant pressure, specific heat at constant volume, and for adiabatic process. I hope you understood this derivation. Till then, read hard, work hard. Thank you very much.